Hi, I'm Mika, and I will be taking part in your alternative psychotherapy routine today. Hate it.
Really?
Loathe it. Yeah, so I like Twiglets, but I don't like this stuff. So what does that mean?
Well, I'll tell you a little bit of trivia that it's up to you whether you decide.
Have you seen that Mr. Bean episode where he runs out of Twiglets? So he goes to the window and he chops the little twigs off the trees and puts them with him on the plate. And then the guests are eating twigs and he makes sure to get all the real Twiglets for himself. Take it
this
away.
This is the kind of gold that we're after.
Good old trick. On your way home, before you leave on a night out, set your bed up, right? Undo your bed so that it's all ready to jump into when you're home. Pick up your chair by your desk, put it on top of the bed, put a glass of water, a couple of aspirins on top of the chair, on top of the bed. By the time you stumble home in the morning, you'll have to remove the chair in order to get into your bed because it's in the bed. And in order to remove the chair, you have to pick up the glass and the aspirin that are on there, and you'll feel a lot better in the morning.
It's a teddy bear. I don't know, you know.
It just makes me think of Winnie the Pooh. I know it shouldn't, but it does.
Are you a fan of Winnie the Pooh?
I'm a huge fan of Winnie the Pooh, yeah. The Tao of Pooh is a brilliant book. Everyone should read it. It takes you to spiritual heights in the most infantile way. And as far as I'm concerned, that's good.
If you had to pick one person who was the ultimate, who was allowed to be Winnie the Pooh, who would it be?
It would have to be... Who would that be? On the planet?
Anyone.
It would be... that man right there, the builder, he is Winnie the Pooh. He's whistling to himself, and he's happy. Woo! Oh, God. This reminds me of Lebanon. This reminds me of, there's this place called Zahle. And you go there and you sit in these restaurants. It's an area in Lebanon, and you just sit, and they've got like fountains and waterfalls, and you eat these meals that last about 7 hours. And for every course, you move to a different table. And then you get to the fruit course, and it was always melon. That's kind of boring and soppy, but. What is this?
It's a CD of Queen music. I can't...
Oh, okay, so it's not like some awful tribute band.
No, I can't be sure.
Oh, no, these are originals.
This is the real one. So, you know, are you a fan, you reference?
I'm not as huge a fan as some people say I am, or would like me to be, but I am a fan, definitely. I mean, Roy Thomas Baker... amazing producer, Freddie Mercury, incredible vocalist, genius songwriter, put together all the other elements of a band, and you have a classic band. Absolute classic band. You can't mock them, whether you love them or you hate them, just like Marmite, whether you were weaned on them as a child, as you like to say, it doesn't matter. You can't take it away from them. They're part of rock history. I was just in India. For Christmas, I went to Rajasthan, and because we all got a wonderful case of Delhi belly, literally every single one of us in our group, we were all feeling really ill in our hotel in Delhi, and we bought packs of cards, and we were sitting in the lobby of the hotel, and we decided to start playing a game, and they ran up to us and told us off, because public card playing in India is illegal. In order to deal with gambling. So you learn something new every day with Delhi Belly. how much will the psychotherapy session cost?
This one's in the house.
Oh, cheers.